Hey everyone, it's Triple Mango Threat, and today we're going over the top 10 win cons in Commander. But before we get too far, don't forget to pick up some Mango Family merch. And if you would like to get any of these cards, click the deck list below. Roll the intro. Starting in no particular order, we have Approach of the Second Sun for 6 and 1 white. It's a sorcery. If Approach of the Second Sun was cast from your hand and you've cast another spell named Approach of the Second Sun this game, you win the game. Otherwise, put Approach of the Second Sun into its owner's library, 7th from the top, and you gain 7 life. Now, to clear up any confusion, you can always go to gatherer.wizards.com. When it comes to the rulings of this card, there are several. The ones I want to speak on in particular are: as your second spell of the Second Sun resolves, it checks only whether the first one was cast, not whether the first one resolved. If your first Approach of the Second Sun was countered, you still win the game as your second one resolves. Approach of the Second Sun has no effect until it's resolving. If the second one you cast is countered, you won't win the game. It's very important that we know exactly what our cards can do and cannot do. If anyone disagrees with you, you can always lead them to the website or ask a local judge. Mechanized Production for 2 and 2 blue, it's an enchantment aura. Enchant artifact you control. At the beginning of your upkeep, create a token that's a copy of enchanted artifact. Then if you control 8 or more artifacts with the same name as one another, you win the game. So this is a fairly simple win con for artifact-based decks. You can enchant a very powerful artifact or even a mana rock and get more mana over time. What's really important is that you protect Mechanized Production because it will at most take 8 turns for you to get those 8 copies. Of course, there are cards to make this quicker, but keep in mind, in 8 turns, our opponents could come up with a removal spell. Up next is Mortal Kombat for 2 and 2 black. It's an enchantment. At the beginning of your upkeep, if 20 or more creature cards are in your graveyard, you win the game. So as I'm doing research for the video, I come across this card. I have never seen this card, and it's really good for decks that have at least 20 creatures. First deck I thought of that could use this card is Marin of Clan Nel'Toth. For those who don't know, to summarize Marin, as a commander, she is very good at bringing back our creatures from the graveyard to our hand or battlefield. So it's very likely we will have a lot of creatures in our graveyard with this deck. And of course, we don't have to use just Marin as a commander only for this win con. As long as there's black in the deck and a bunch of creatures in our graveyard, I highly recommend this card as one of your win cons. One card you may be familiar with is Hellkite Tyrant for 4 and 2 red. It's a 6/5 dragon with flying and trample. Whenever Hellkite Tyrant deals combat damage to a player, gain control of all artifacts that player controls. At the beginning of your upkeep, if you control 20 or more artifacts, you win the game. So again, we have another artifact-based win con, and it's very powerful. Not only are we stealing one of our opponent's artifacts, but they are possibly taking 6 damage as well. It's definitely not a fun card to have played against you, but it's really nice to grab your opponent's mana rocks and nice artifact creatures. Next up is Helix Pentacle. For 1 green, it's an enchantment that has Shroud. Pay X, put X tower counters on Helix Pentacle. At the beginning of your upkeep, if there are 100 or more tower counters on Helix Pentacle, you win the game. Helix Pentacle is very on theme with green, having us pay a huge amount of mana to win the game, and it has Shroud. So the only way our opponents could possibly remove this is through a board wipe or something that would return it to our hand. Luckily, it's not expecting us to pay 100 mana in one turn, which I know some of us like to make more than hundreds of mana in one turn, but realistically, this gives us another way to make our opponents sweat, and any leftover mana we have can go toward this enchantment. Test of Endurance for 2 and 2 white, it's an enchantment. At the beginning of your upkeep, if you have 50 or more life, you win the game. Having 50 or more life in Commander isn't a hard thing to accomplish when you're playing white. One commander that would be really busted with this card is Alloro, Ageless Ascetic. To summarize Alloro, you will gain 2 life at your upkeep, whether he is on the battlefield or in your command zone. Many players see him as the first to have eminence before the 2017 commanders. So again, I really recommend this card for a win con if you're playing a life gain deck and need some way to finish the game. My playgroup is very familiar with Laboratory Maniac for 2 and a blue. It's a 2/2 human wizard. If you would draw a card while your library has no cards in it, you win the game instead. This is used as a last resort, or really the main point of a deck is to get Lab Maniac and mill yourself or draw yourself out. Normally in a game of Magic, if you are to draw a card and you have no cards in your library, you would lose. But of course, blue loves knowledge and manipulation, so we have this win con. If you love to draw cards and want to win by drawing cards, this is the way to do it. Revel in Riches for 4 and a black, it's an enchantment. Whenever a creature an opponent controls dies, create a colorless treasure artifact token with tap, sacrifice this artifact, add 1 mana of any color to your mana pool. At the beginning of your upkeep, if you control 10 or more treasures, you win the game. In Magic, the color black is well known for killing their opponent's creatures. This is a great win con for the color, and you make a bunch of treasure tokens that give you mana. This is very helpful, and if we just so happen to have 10 at our upkeep, we win. Up next is Chance Encounter for 2 and 2 red, it's an enchantment. Whenever you win a coin flip, put a luck counter on Chance Encounter. At the beginning of your upkeep, if Chance Encounter has 10 or more luck counters on it, you win the game. This card is based around coin flips, which was a big fad in my playgroup about 1-2 years ago when Battle Bond came out, and it seemed like everyone was building a red-blue coin flip deck. So if you happen to want to build a coin flip deck, I would really recommend this card for you. And finally, we have Epic Struggle for 2 and 2 green, it's an enchantment. At the beginning of your upkeep, if you control 20 or more creatures, you win the game. This win con is really great for a deck with at least 20 creatures in it, or if you have a huge token making deck. Add a Doubling Season, Parallel Lives, Anointed Procession, and we have a great token making machine. Not only these cards are good for tokens, but of course there are other cards that can help us but take a bit longer to accomplish our goal of 20 creatures. Populate in green and white is a great option for this win con, and I'm sure there are many others. So once again, pick this card up if you have a bunch of creatures in your deck. So that was the top 10 win cons in Commander. If you liked this video, leave a thumbs up. If you think I missed an important win con, comment below. And if you want to see more of this Mango content, consider subscribing. We are now at 63 subscribers, making our way to 100. Thank you all so much for your continued support. I can't wait to make more content for you all. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.